am Billionaire Charlie, man. I'm back at it again, man. Thanks to all the people out there that support the channel, man, and that support me, man. Y'all helping me grow each and every day, man. And don't forget, man, I got a lot of affiliate market, Amazon things right in the link below. Y'all go purchase y'all some nice and amazing items, man. And also, come join me on my Facebook group, you know what I'm saying? Amazon Best Affordable Products, man. I'm going to put the link right there in the bottom, you know what I'm saying? So y'all can go over there and check that out, man. And remember, cash tag Billionaire Charlie, put in your donation. And I'm also on the Patreon, man. We doing that thing, yeah, dig? You know what I'm saying? But look, man, we're going to talk about it, man. Jemele Hill, man, speaking on Marcellus Wallace, man, on the whole cabinet situation, man. And I'm going to get my thoughts on that whole situation. You know, Marcellus Wallace, he's still running his lips, still running his mouth. See, let me teach y'all about this individual, Marcellus Wallace, man. Let me teach you about this. See, this guy right here is a demonstration that when we used to go to school, it always that person in the classroom that couldn't stand you, but they didn't have the guts to speak out because everybody else liked you. Everybody else would cap in it. And Marcellus Wallace didn't feel, he wasn't feeling him at all. He didn't want to say nothing until Jay-Z came out there, did that deal. And he was like, yeah, it's my time now. I can go in on him now. I can say what I want to say now because Jay-Z. But the thing is, Jay-Z don't support what you're saying. You know what I'm saying? It's like, really don't, man. I guarantee you, if you was to ask Jay-Z those same questions he asking, they be asking Marcellus Wallace on the Vlad TV and also on TMZ. I guarantee you, Jay-Z won't answer him the same way as he did about Kaepernick. And him, Jemele Hill, she was right about everything she was saying. He was going to an ignorant place when he would start talking about race and he's not black enough and his girl is this and that. And then he had the nerve to do a press run and try to clear up his image because everybody was flaming him up. And he's still saying the same thing, which making everything look bad, you know what I'm saying, on himself. Because ain't nobody going to ride with him like they're going to ride with Jay. They'll throw him under the bus any day, you know what I'm saying? So the position he taking is not going to benefit him in any form or fashion. He can do the jump, Vlad. He can do all the media sources. You want Breakfast Club, you know what I'm saying? And they're gonna flame him up regardless, man. He's coming with an ignorant standpoint, point blank, period, man. You know what I'm saying? That's the way I feel, man. 100%. You feel what I'm saying? What he was doing, it didn't really matter and stuff of that nature, man. Why is he doing it now? And it's just all the questioning for foolishness. You know what I mean? It's just foolish to me. You know? Marcellus Wallace. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, man, let's talk about it, man. So much going on. Mac Miller, man. They found out the drug dealer that gave him the dose that had him overdose and all of that, man. They finally got the guy. He's in custody, man. And he's about to do probably penitentiary life messing with that white boy, you know? He's going to get penitentiary a lot messing with that white boy. You know, good and well, you don't be messing with no white boys, okay? And you can be that, you going down, all the way down. You're going to do just like this. Sir, go ahead and get a plea deal, or you going to the jail. Life in a penitentiary. Y'all know how that go, you know what I'm saying? For real, man. Man, I've been seeing all this crazy news, man. I'm like, wow, man, it's wild out here, man. Remy Ma talking about she quitting rap. Now, I respect Rem. I like Rem, Papoose, all of them, man. But I feel like at this point in her career, nobody really cares if Remy Ma quit rap because she haven't been putting out anything. And I'm saying that respectfully. Like, she ain't been putting out nothing for real. Like, we don't really hear from Remy Ma like that for us to even be like, oh, we're going to miss her. You know what I'm saying? She did a hot song, you know what I'm saying, with Fat Joe. I mean, I feel like she make her best music with Fat Joe. You know what I'm saying? For real. You know what I'm saying? I would love to see Fat Joe and Remy Ma do something with, what's the boy name? Zaytoven. From Atlanta. I would love to see them work with him. Because I think they just need a different sound. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's a new era now. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man. I heard that. Then I heard Megan Thee Stallion and the Nicki Minaj thing. And I wanted to speak on it. I say, man, she quit twerking and all of that. Because Megan shined on her and everybody going in on something. Her butt stiff because she got all them shots in the butt. You know what I'm saying? And all that's going on. Jiggle, jiggle. Stop, stop. Megan joint jiggling because her junk all real. You know what I'm saying? Nicki Minaj joint, like, it's plastic in that joint. Like, come on, move now. Come on. come on and move now. Nicki Minaj on with Stiffy, Stiff Step. You know what I'm saying? It was stiff. You know what I'm saying? Right, look, look. Everybody said Megan about to take that queen spot. You know what I'm saying? Over Cardi. I say, man, one thing about Cardi, she knew how to rock that junk. Shh. Cardi and Megan, man, that's who she should have had in her video. Now everybody finding out. She should have had Cardi B in her jank. Man, Cardi would have got it on. if Cardi can't... Yeah. What? And you know I'm a Cardi B fan. I ain't just saying it because I'm a fan of Cardi B. I'm just saying, dog. Like, if you had Megan Thee Stallion and Cardi B would have got it in. That ass would have been... Do. Cardi B ass is... She also got it set, boy. Cheat on what? Who am I cheating on? Cardi B? No, I'm going home to my old lady. I don't need you. I'm going home, cuz. I'm going home to my old lady. I'm not cheating on Cardi B, no sir. One of the hottest girls in the game. I said, I'll say, be tripping. And if you do something, boy, you better be somebody that never called or nothing. Real talk. Cheating on Cardi B? Oh, hell no. You better not lose that junk. She gonna be a billionaire real soon. Watch this. She started doing makeup and all of that. She gonna be a billionaire easy. You know what I'm saying? She's so influential. You know what I'm saying? Cardi B. Nicki Minaj is over, man. That's over. That train is over. Now there's Megan Thee Stallion and Cardi B. Nobody really checking for the Nicki thing no more. I'm trying to tell you, man. Like her fans, everything about her gonna start to die off. You know what I'm saying? I just feel like Cardi B got a better personality. I never really seen Megan Thee Stallion, you know, interviews and stuff like that. So I don't really know her personality like that. But like I say, when you got Cardi B and then you got Nicki, more people would rather deal with Cardi B than Nicki because Cardi B is like a street joint. She's straight hood, straight regular. Nicki Minaj began to start acting bougie. Like, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to go there. Now she's starting to tap in with the people. But I'm saying, you can't play Lil Wayne, bro, because Lil Wayne is Wayne. Drake is Drake. You know what I'm saying? Like, women artists don't really last that long anywhere in the hip-hop game. We all know that. You know what I'm saying? That's a fact. That's why Young M.A. The reason why Young M.A. would never be a big star is because she looked like a guy, walk around like a guy, mess with guys. She would never be a Cardi B or any of them. Like, she made one hit and disappeared. And nobody gonna ever, because it's just the thing, man. Women like Cardi B, men like Cardi B. You know what I'm saying? So you got, like, a large group of people loving you. When you do Young M.A., it's a mixed feeling for that. You know what I'm saying? Like I say, people say that stigma had went away, but it really didn't. You know what I'm saying? That's why I felt like, what was the girl that was going against Remy Ma? Dang, I forget her name right now, man. What is it? Lady Luck? Is it Lady Luck? I think her name is Lady Luck. That's why I felt like Lady Luck never really made it that far. I feel like at that time when she was battling Remy and stuff like that, she should have been a bigger artist, but she was gay. And it affected her. It affected her. You know what I'm saying? Seriously, like when you admit to that to the public and then you try to sell records, it just don't work. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I don't see Young M.A. making no more big hits unless it got somebody on the joint. Because she not shaking no butt, she not doing nothing. She ain't dressed like no woman, she dressed like a dude. It's like it's not going to sell, that's not marketable. I hate to say it, you know what I'm saying? But I guarantee if Young M.A. dressed like a girl, shaking butt and all of that, she's going to sell records, she's going to sell. But right now, nobody ain't trying to hear no Young M.A., not no females or nobody, bro. Nobody trying to hear that. I'm just being real, bro. They still to this day got that stigma in hip-hop. People are like, nah, y'all, they ain't thinking like that. Bro, people ain't really rocking with not to be no disrespectful turn or try to be disrespectful. I'm just saying people ain't really rocking with no studs like that. You think people would rather see Young M.A. or Megan Thee Stallion? Megan Thee Stallion, every time. Cardi B or Young M.A.? Cardi B! You know what I'm saying? Every time, bro, because of that look, how she look, like, that still affect a lot, bro. And especially we in the screaming market where records don't sell like it used to back in the day. So you got to put that in consideration, right? I'm just being real, man. Nicki Minaj telling myself she about to quit rap, quit twerking. I said, girl, you need to stop. It's crazy, though, because Nicki used to can romp, though, but she ain't Cardi B romping with the twerking, or she ain't Megan Thee Stallion with the twerking. Nah, neither one of them, dog. Like, she ain't messing with Cardi B at all, man. I don't care what nobody say. You know, she could be a stripper, all of that. She know how to throw it. You know what I'm saying? For real, man. I'm just a Cardi B fan all the way, man. Not because she a blood or nothing like that. I just rock with Cardi B, man. You feel me? Nicki Minaj, I just don't... I been feeling like she did a lot of fake stuff in the industry. And then she did that thing to Meek Mill. I really didn't like that thing she did to Meek Mill, man. I feel like that was trifling, man. You know what I'm saying? You don't know big Meek Mill fan. I ain't like that too much. I know Meek ain't gonna really speak on it or say too much about it. He's a man's man just like me, but... Nah, bro, that was wrong what she did to Meek Mills, man. And then she get supposed to be getting married to this guy. And I'm like, how she doing all that when she was with Meek? And how long you been knowing this guy? Like, what's been going on? What's the relationship with this? This look kind of weird to me, dog. Straight up. It look kind of weird to me. You getting married and all of this with this dude. How long you been messing with this guy? I say you can't trust nobody these days, man. That's a fact, man. I know everybody want to get mad. Oh, Charlie, you can't say this. Oh, Charlie, you can't say that. No, I'm going to say you can't trust nobody nowadays, bro. How she getting married with a whole nigga telling her she got a baby and all of this, and we ain't seen this nigga ever. I'm just being real. All of a sudden, she with Meek Mill. All of a sudden, she with this guy, and they getting a baby, and she getting married and all of that. First of all, she's the control freak. She can't control Meek like she can control this guy. This guy ain't pimping on her level. Even though Meek ain't had her money at that particular time, he still was an artist making millions of dollars. You know what I'm saying? So let's stop it, man. Let's stop it with this, man. That man ain't on Meek Mill level, point blank, period. And I don't care who trying to take up for Nicki for this. She trying to be just like Cardi B. Just like I said last time. Now she can't keep up with... She trying to attach herself to every heart, hat, women artist that's out to try to keep herself relevant. Now Megan Thee Stallion. She couldn't do that to Cardi B because she wasn't having it. You know what I'm saying? That's fate to me, man. Then we got the Nipsey Hussle thing. They say somebody trying to, a singer trying to get at his estate, man. I say, dang, the world is crazy out here, man. Really, really crazy, man. You're going to this man's estate talking about he owe you some money and this and that. And the family is going through death and all of that. I'm like, how cruel can people be in this world, G? It's like, dang, bro. Now, who else gonna come up with a man in this state, man? Now, they did it to Michael Jackson, now Nipsey Hussle. It's despicable to see people doing this, bro. Like, out of all the money you can make in the world, you gotta come for this guy. I would let that money go. I'm just being honest. I'd be like, man, y'all keep that for the family and his daughter, man. I don't need that money. I can make another hit. People so weirdos, man. I'm out, man. I gotta go, man. Being there, Charlie, man. I love all of y'all out there. Don't forget to continue to support me, man. I love y'all.